system reboot. Social systems seem to be institutes of trepidation, hiding the truth in endless paper-made trails of documentation, and sanctions are made for threats to the community, where you and me proctor test the simple means to disguise the lies bureaucracy provides to make it seem like we're trying to make real change, when the real change is in pockets while sockets of social inequality still exist, since we can't seem to visualize this in the green gluttony of official standards, bottomless pits. We as community advocates stand corrected every time rejected by the youth who say to this system they won't accept it. Disgruntled, we fumble and making a difference, whether standing in front of classes or in front of a pulpit. So we rearrange some things to satisfy job requirements, transition from what I'm learning to a classical conditioning environment, and raise children of this age who don't think on their own. Get real attitudinal with them, don't allow them to voice opinion because you ain't grown. We disown brilliant minds because they spend too much time disrupting our mundane classes. And the issue is crystal clear, but some of us have 20/50 vision and we need glasses. Still, we diagnose and prescribe, treat some kids as magazines. We subscribe to the minds that pacify our egos. We roll to the beat of our own drums and become callous with malice in our hearts. And instead of imparting, we depart from the mission. The mission to witness and save and behave like psychotic, neurotic, robotic machines that glean from the rules and regulations, filled with robust language that says nothing but how our children are becoming statistics. Anytime or once a month, youth convention is enough to make a significant difference. I'd say we're sadly mistaken. Or like the kids say, man, you fake. Or I seriously misinformed. I urge ye therefore, brethren, to go within arm's reach and teach from the depths of your soul, because kids can't read and write, and frankly, that mess is getting old. We should have gotten over that since we stopped being sold into slavery. And now the issue is no longer just a man, but it's our own lack of bravery. And it angers me to see the perpetuation of this cycle, like recycled old rags. We hand down our trash to the next generation and then act as if we don't understand their misbehavior, as if they haven't learned it from this makeshift nation. Advocates of the truth have been silenced because when they stand up, there's this unsettling feeling of job insecurity. And now the focus is no longer youth development, but it's workforce truancy. And if we're absent, our kids are lacking or strapping or being branded with a label. I say 98% of them are fabled, just the way in which the hand rocks the cradle. And it's cyclical. Nothing at all about this set of mystical. We draw kids because we don't want to exert the energy to teach to their needs. They show us a little activity or challenge and we say to them, girl, believe. I got mine, so you gotta get yours. Never take the time to see more than hoard anger and frustration and dispense it like it's a newfound language by parents thereby anticipating modifications, as if they're not the number one factors in their child's success. We need to adjust this redress of grievance. Stop passing the buck and deal with our own demons, because it's your behavior that can make or break your child's future. Maybe if you were focused on being more of an example, your child would be advancing lessons of Kama Sutra. And a rooster is crowing, it's a new day, and we need to start going in the direction of truth. And the truth is, we need a systematic reboot. Reboot the way we think about the educational process. Unlock this door to change like a locksmith. And there is no one facet to this situation. But sitting and twiddling our thumbs will only cause more anguish. Patience is a commodity we cannot afford. Stop scratching the surface and get to the core. It's us on the crux of catastrophe. And I'll be daggone if I stand by watching while it's happening. We need to begin to grasp the issues. Stop wiping away the dirt and grime of this time with soft felt tissue and arise to the challenge of imbalance within the culture. Social systems are devouring our children like vultures, and we stand on the sidelines as if we're spectators. This ain't the NBA, NFL, you ain't in the limelight, and even if you were, forget the haters. And arise toward momentous change. Let your veins flow with compassion and blood. Whether you're from the hood, suburbs, sticks, it's all good. We should stand up for what we believe in and get behind the lives of these kids. And now that the cat's out of the bag, the underlying issues are no longer a secret. Let's strive towards new horizons. The truth is before us. We don't need to find it. Change. We definitely need it.